accepted. We are talking about drops and bubbles now. Why drops are the way they are, and why they are spherical in shape, and why bubbles?
When I'm saying something, you don't do all that.
Okay. Alright, so we are talking about drops and bubbles now. Bubble is exactly like balloon, right? It has a membrane inside which there is an air. Okay, so we are going to study drops and bubbles. Technically, we will study how it is and what is the pressure inside, and how much pressure will result to which size of the drop, and so on and so forth. Okay, so the reason why bubbles and drops exist is because of the surface tension. Okay, so let us try to analyze it. First, tell me, what is the difference between drop and a bubble? Drop, bubble is hollow. Okay, so if there is air inside liquid, is it a drop or a bubble? It is drop. It is a drop. Okay, so the technical definition of drop is it should have only one interface. Please write down. Drop has one surface or one interface, whereas a bubble has two interfaces or surface. Now you realize that air trapped inside liquid is air drop, but people say that it is a bubble, when the air bubble is inside water. No, it is not a bubble. Technically it is a drop, because it has only one interface between air and liquid. That's it. Okay. Whereas that toy you have seen, where the kids, they blow bubble out of the soap solution. Okay. That is bubble, because it has two interfaces. Inside that spherical shape, this air, then this is the bubble. This is air. Then this is liquid, and there is air again. So first surface is inside, other surface is outside. Two surfaces. Okay, a drop has only one surface. Okay, that you need to understand. That technically, you have written, right? Yes. Technically, the bubble has two interfaces, and the drop has only one interface. Now, this is, let us say, a drop of water. It's a drop of water. Surface tension is, let's say, S. Inner pressure is PIN, or just write PI. And outer pressure is PO. Okay? Now, assume that this drop has expanded slightly. It is just an assumption. Suppose the radius was R, and very very small expansion, let's say delta R expansion, has happened. Okay? Any doubt? Now please apply work energy theorem before the expansion, after the expansion. The expansion is so less that inner pressure remains unchanged. If you have more amount of expansion, the inner pressure will change. Apply work energy theorem.
It expands with very small velocity.
No velocity. Negligible. And this drop is not moving at all. In short, change in kinetic energy is zero.
Thank you.
P1 and P2, two pressures are there, they will do the work, right? The force is pressure into area, surface area.
Now, here is the thing. Till now, every time we have
we dealt with a scenario in which a bucket is filled with water. Outside pressure is, let's say, atmosphere. Just inside the surface also we have taken atmospheric pressure only. And then we have written P A plus rho GH. Yes or no? The pressure just outside the fluid was equal to pressure just inside. The first time I am telling you pressure just inside is more than pressure just outside. The reason is, first, surface tension, and second, the radius was infinite in this case. It was flat. So when this R is infinite, 2s by R becomes 0. Getting it? But if surface is curved, then pressure just outside is different from pressure just inside. You can't just say that outside atmospheric pressure, so just inside also atmospheric pressure, so that plus rho gh. No. That is true only when surface is horizontal or when surface tension is zero. Getting it? All of you? Alright? Now, this is for the drop. What do you think for the bubble? How will you do it? For the bubble, if you follow the same process, what is the only difference you will see? There are two surfaces. Two surfaces are there. So, the S will be multiplied by 2S. This will be 2S. So, this will be 2S. S will be 2S. So, for bubble, Pi minus P naught will be 4S by R. This is for the bubble. This is for the drop. Okay? Fine? Now, if you have that same toy which kids play, as in they pour it on a soap solution, then blow air on it. If you blow the air very fast, the radius of the bubbles will be lesser or more? Why? The pressure inside the bubble will be more or less if you are blowing fast. Pressure will be more. Pressure will be more. Outside pressure is fixed. Atmospheric pressure. So difference in pressure will be large. So R should be less. So if you want the bubble to have more radius, you should blow it slowly. Okay? Getting it? Right? But earlier we have discussed that if velocity is more, pressure decreases. But I am here when I am taking this example, I am not assuming that the fluid is flowing continuously. Fluid is flowing, it has kinetic energy, half rho v square is there. As soon as it gets inside the bubble, kinetic energy is lost, it got converted into pressure energy. Getting it? So more is the kinetic energy, more will the pressure energy. Half rho v square will be equal to P. Alright, so that is why if you blow with higher velocity, inside pressure will be more, difference in pressure will be more, and R of the bubble will be lesser. Okay? Now there will be a scenario where you will not see a complete drop or complete bubble. Even if the surface is like this, you know, even if it is like this, then also you can treat as if it is a part of a bigger drop. Fine? You can treat as if it is a part of a bigger drop. But how will you say which is inside and which is outside? Because the formula is for inner pressure minus outer pressure is 2s by r. So which is inner here? The concave side is the inner. Please write down. The concave side has higher pressure than the convex side. Okay, concave side has a higher pressure. Now we are going to use this property itself to talk about the capillary rise. Okay, and capillary rise is one of the very important topic, at least for your school exams. Alright, so please write down capillary rise. Have you seen capillary? Is it like a test tube?
Yes.
Most capillary is open from both the sides. Alright, it is open from both the sides. क्या हुआ? खड़ा, पीछे बैठ, go back. पीछे पीछे. Continuously talking. Okay, this is capillary. It is open from both the ends. Outside pressure is, let's say, atmospheric pressure. So pressure on the capillary here, let's say this is capillary, so pressure till where the fluid is, let's say here is fluid, inside the pressure will be atmospheric pressure only. Okay, so ideally the water should not rise up. Getting it? Had it been test tube, if upper surface would have been sealed and here is vacuum, then water rises, it becomes barometer. Alright, but upper surface is open. So if atmospheric pressure is here, then pressure over here will be more than atmospheric pressure, PA plus rho GH. But it should not be, because here also atmospheric pressure is there. So water should not rise up. But it is seen that water rises up. And that is because of the surface tension. Alright, so this is what we are going to discuss now. So please draw a new drawing. Draw a thicker capillary this time. Actually the capillaries are very very thin. You need to draw thicker because there are angles and everything else you need to draw. Let's say this is a capillary and the capillary rise is H. Okay. Outside pressure is P naught. PA ले लो, atmospheric pressure, PA. Okay, and it is seen that it develops a curvature like this. Okay, and this curvature is, we are treating it as if it is a part of a sphere. It is a part of a bigger sphere that is not complete. Okay, so if you draw tangent at this point and this capillary is there, this angle theta is the angle of contact. So please write down, angle of contact is the angle of contact is the angle between, angle of contact is the angle between the capillary, between the capillary and the tangent, and the tangent on the surface of fluid at the point of contact. Okay, so theta is the angle, and since you are having the capillary, your own capillary, so you must know what is the diameter of the capillary or the radius of capillary, right? So you already know what is the radius of the capillary. Let's say radius of the capillary is A. Now can you tell me what is the radius of this part of the sphere? If angle theta is given to you, what is the radius of that curve that you are seeing? Mathematics, geometry. If A is the radius of the capillary, find out the radius of the third surface. Is it A by cos theta? All of you getting it? Tell me, what if theta is 9, theta is 0? Then it will be a hemisphere, yes or no? If theta is 0, it will be a hemisphere. So radius of the curved surface should be equal to radius of the capillary only. So whatever answer you are getting, if you put theta equal to 0, it should give you A only. Anybody else got A by cos theta as radius? No. Nobody is trying also. Where will be the, can you tell something about the center of this curved surface? Where it will be? It will be along that line, center line only, right? The center will be along this line somewhere. What else can you say about the center? If you draw a perpendicular to the tangent, here will be the center. Yes or no? Radius is what? This is radius, distance between this point, point number 1, point number 2. Distance between 1 and 2 is a radius. Right? This is 90 degree. What about this angle? How much is this? This is 90 degree. So this angle will be what? This is 90 minus theta. So this is theta. Okay? So basically, R cos theta should be equal to A, or R is equal to A by cos theta. Fine. So we have got the radius of the curved surface now, and why I am finding the radius of the curved surface? What is the reason? What is the reason? So that I can use pi minus p naught is equal to 2s by r. In that r is needed. Okay? Why I am trying to find the pressure here inside the fluid? So that I can use this pressure plus rho gs to find pressure over here and equate that to atmospheric pressure. Okay? So this entire thought process why we are doing all this. Okay? So p, which pressure will be more? This pressure or pressure just inside? Atmospheric pressure will be more because that is concave side. And if you imagine this complete hemisphere, atmospheric pressure will go inside of the drop. So P, A, which drop it is? The air drop or the liquid drop? Air drop. So P, A minus P in is equal to what? 2s by r, r is a by cos theta. Okay? Any doubt till now? Alright, so I am getting inner pressure to be equal to pa minus 2s cos theta by a. Understood? Right? Now since I have got pressure just inside the fluid, I can use this plus rho gh to find pressure over there. Okay? So I know that pi plus rho gh, which is pa minus 2s cos theta by a, this pi plus rho gh, this should be equal to what? Pa only. Should be the pressure same as here, it is a horizontal line. Okay, so PA and PA goes away. So I am getting the capillary radius H. It's very important derivation, please let me know if you are not getting it. 2S by rho g cos theta. A rho g for hemispherical shape, theta is 0, so cos of theta is 1. This is called the capillary rise. It will go down. See, this is done, right? And any doubt? See, we are ignoring the difference, this thing we are ignoring. Okay, you must know what you are ignoring. So that, otherwise pressure could be different just inside here, here, here because of the height itself. But that we can ignore, it is very less. Any doubt here in the derivation? No doubts, doubtless. Okay, so what Kripan is saying that if capillary is there and the shape is like this, then what will happen is that it will be down, it will not go up because the pressure here has to be more than outside. Are you getting it? So pressure here is more than atmospheric pressure. This pressure is greater than atmospheric pressure. And there is atmospheric pressure here. So this atmospheric pressure plus rho gh should be equal to that pressure. That is why it has to go down. If shape is like that. You can derive it now. Okay. Please write down a numerical. I'll take 15 more minutes. Okay. Please note down 1.5 only, 15 minutes. Okay. Lower end of the capillary tube. There is a capillary tube of, if you are able to solve this numerical, surface tension topic is done for you forever. Diameter of the capillary is 2 mm. And always do not use the ready-made formula. So we have a derivation of capillary rise. So do not be like, okay, super pilot, the vatta mara, okay, this, when this happens, this is OGH by Viscosity. No, don't do all that. Whenever a numerical on capillary rise come, I want you to derive it then and there. Because situations will be different. So little bit difference here and there, you will not be able to use a direct formula. You must know how it is derived. So that you can use that while problem solving. Not the final expression, okay? Attempt this. Capillary tube has diameter 2 mm. It is dipped. A centimeter below the surface of water. What is the pressure required in a tube to blow a hemispherical bubble? Now they say it is bubble, but it is a drop. Technically it is a drop. Hemispherical bubble at its end inside water. Surface tension is this 7.3 into 10 to minus 2. Atmospheric pressure is 1.01 10 to the power 5. All SI units. Density of water is 1000. G is 9.8. All SI units. What do we need to find out? How much should be the pressure to blow the hemispherical, you are blowing a hemispherical bubble inside the water like this. Okay, this is inside the water, it is dipped. How much? 8 centimeter. So this is the hemispherical. You can't use direct formula here, situation is different. There is air, the entire this thing, capillary is filled with air. Not only entire capillary, it creates a hemispherical shape of air inside the water also.
job is as in? So what do you think is lower?
Lower inside the water surface?
Lower.
Right, you take the capillary and put it inside the water and then you are blowing air in it. And on the end which is inside the water, a hemisphere will be formed with the air. You need to find pressure in the capillary. Pressure plus rho gh. So I can write it as 2s by r plus atmospheric pressure plus rho g h, where h is 8 centimeter. So this is the pressure inside the capillary, and excess pressure will be this minus Pa. Getting it? So pay attention to the derivation. Alright? Now the way we have derived, very similar to the way we have solved here, but we are not directly using the expression. That mode is gone now. That works in 9th and 10th. Formula they are start finding out where is S, where is rho, and subsequently come the answer. No, that will not work now. Get rid of that mode. Is it clear? And this is from your school textbook, solved exercise. Alright? Now, just few things. For example, when you suppose you are washing your clothes and the cloth has a lot of dirt. Alright? And when you don't use a soap, the dirt usually doesn't come out easily. But if you use a soap, the dirt comes out easily. The reason? What? Surface G. Listen. When the dirt is on the shirt, let us say, there's a surface tension between shirt and the dirt. Okay? And when you dissolve detergent inside the water and that comes in contact with the dirt, the surface tension between dirt and the detergent is less than the surface tension between shirt and the dirt. Because of that, if dirt dissolves with the detergent, it will decrease its energy because surface tension is less. If surface tension between soap and the dirt is less, okay, then if dirt mixes with soap, it is decreasing its energy. Yes or no? So because of that, it easily mixes up, because every object in the universe wants to decrease its energy. So if it mixes with the dirt, the soap, and decreases its energy, that is what happens. Okay? And have you seen that in a banana leaf, if you put water, it doesn't spread on the banana leaf, it dances around. It remains drop only. The reason? Again, surface tension. If it mixes with the banana leaf, surface tension between water and banana is very high, banana leaf. So it doesn't spread on the banana leaf, otherwise it will increase its energy. Okay, and similarly, have you heard of sophromycin or boroline, boroplus and all those antiseptic cream which spreads easily on your surface, on the skin, right? The reason? Because surface tension between those antiseptic cream and the skin is very less. So that is why they spread across easily. Otherwise they will not. While they spread on the surface, they are decreasing their energy. Okay, so same thing you can understand from the bond point of view. Okay, using chemistry. But same thing we can understand by using the physics, as in from the energy point of view. Alright, so this chapter is done. Alright, so we have completed this chapter. And last 1 hour, whatever is time left now, we'll be focusing on KVPY or JEE advanced level questions. Those who have done the homework, please show me the homework, and others quickly move out.